Hi, this is JC with Route4Me. Who do we have in the call?
Hi, JC. My name is Steven.
Hi, Steven. How are you today?
I'm doing quite well. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good. Thank you. Steven, I understand you have some questions about Route4Me.
I'm just having some difficulty adding new drivers to Route4Me, and I was hoping you could help me out with that.
Okay, that shouldn't be a problem. How many drivers do you have?
We currently have 5.
Okay. And you want to add more drivers?
Yeah. Well, I need to add in, this is a new account. I'm on the trial, so I only have one driver in currently, which is the main user. I just need to figure out how I can add new accounts to Route4Me.
Oh, okay. All right, that shouldn't be a problem. Let's go ahead and go into a Route4Me account and show you how that can be done. All right. So mainly what we need to do is go into your address book section right here on the left-hand side. Go into your address book list. And what we're going to do is we're going to upload a list of addresses. Okay? So once you have your file ready, all you have to do is just go to File, Upload Addresses, look for it. In this case, here's my file. And we're going to upload a list of addresses. As you can see, the system is already geocoded, so I'm just going to add to address book. Do you have any questions so far?
Nope, not so far.
Okay, excellent. So as you can see, I already have a list of addresses in the file. So let's go and take a look on the address book map and what they look like. On the map, you'll be able to see a whole list of all the addresses that you've uploaded, okay? So in this case, what we're going to do is we're going to edit one of these addresses, okay? Which you can do by right-clicking on any of the pins, edit. You can add an alias, okay? You can add a location detail. You can edit custom data, like you can add a county. You can change the number of pieces. You can do additional columns. All these fields that you see here are part of an Excel upload. So if you add this data, this custom data to related to each address as additional columns in your file upload, they will be displayed right here on this window. That makes sense. So you can add as many columns as you would like to your file. They will display right here. Okay. So you can also change the color on your pin. You can change the icon as well. Let's say we're going to call this one green. You can save it, and boom, it changes the color. So you can color code your customers and determine whether it's an active lead, or it's an existing customer, it's a new customer, is it a high-value customer, things like that, right? So another thing you can do is you can add a time window restriction. You can include windows of opportunity in which you can visit this customer. For example, maybe you need to visit a restaurant, and those restaurants are usually receiving hours are between 8 a.m. and 10 a.m., right before the lunch rush. And then also you can create a secondary window if there is an opening after the lunch rush and things like that. That makes sense?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Another thing you can do is also you can schedule this customer and say, I want to visit this customer daily, every 2 days, or weekly. Maybe I want to visit him on Tuesdays every 2 weeks, or Tuesdays and Thursdays every 2 weeks, or 3 weeks, or however many weeks you need to do, monthly and obviously annually, okay? So we're going to save that. And that's all you have to do to set up the custom data onto your accounts. Now, if you wanted to add this this accounts to a route, all you have to do is just go and open your list of routes. And say, for example, let's open this route right here. Open route. And say we need to add some accounts to this route. So what we're going to do is we're going to go into the map settings, activate my address book, and you can see how other stops show up in that area. So I can say, okay, I want to add these two guys right here. So I'm just going to right-click, add route. I can add it after the last stop, or I can add it to the route at the optimal position, which will be the best solution. So let's go ahead and do that. Do you have any questions so far?
Nope.
Excellent. So on the right-hand side, as you can see, your activity feed will show you exactly what's happening. It keeps a record of what changes or what happens on the during the route, so you can just include those stops. What do you think so far?
Yeah, I think it looks good. I like that you can see the other addresses on the map while you're doing this. Would there be an easy way to add one of those addresses, the blue addresses, to that route?
Yeah, like I said, you simply right-click on it, and then add route to last stop, after the last stop, and there it goes. See? Then you can always go into your route section and re-optimize the route to make sure you have the correct position in the sequence. And that will do. So this is how you can actually create new routes with new accounts into your Route4Me. Then also, you can create routes right from your address book list. Obviously, the same options are available in your address book list, where you can actually go onto the far right, edit, and then you can add aliases, change the address, you know, location details, add a group, edit custom data, everything we've already seen. Now, another thing you can do is you can just search for a group of addresses. For example, let's say store one. See how many store ones we have. Oh. See how it filters everything with store one? Obviously, it's bringing up the 164s and whatnot. So let's just say 100s. The filter set by, this is a wide search, so it basically searches on all of the data to create a match, all right? So maybe we can be more specific and say 226. There we go. See that? So
yep.
As you select multiple stops, let's say we want to grab all the stops. So once we select them all, you can see selected 14, and if I delete the search, you can see it would change to selected 14 of 803 accounts that you have in there. You can just plan route we selected, name the route, set up a departure point, you can type in a whole new address, you can schedule it, set up an optimization, maybe you want to plan a single driver route, or you want to balance the route onto two drivers, create a round trip, and create the route. That is basically all you have to do, just as fast as that. So it goes 30 seconds to plan two routes. I'm going to take out the address book so we can see the routes. There they are. What do you think?
Yeah, JC, I think it looks good. This is definitely the information I was missing when I was trying to fumble around by myself. I appreciate the help and the guidance.
Yeah, fantastic. So listen, Steve, right now is obviously I'm just trying to show you how the system works. I would rather put you through an onboarding session, which is basically a training session. Once you activate your account, we'll give you all the help you need to learn how every functionality works within the Route4Me, and we'll make sure that all of your routes are planned efficiently and in a fast, efficient manner, okay? So why don't we go ahead and activate your account, skip the trial, and we'll put you on through the training session so it makes the process a lot faster. Would that be okay?
Yep, sounds great, JC. Thank you.
All right, let's go ahead and do that. I'll send you that email, and I'll call you right back.